Well, welcome to working on a head gasket number two for this Chevy Equinox. We're going to just kind of start off by pulling these dowel pins out. I was actually kind of impressed with the design because it's like a roll pin where it's got a seam in it, so they come out really nicely, unlike many other dowel pins I've dealt with in the past. Just before you put all this back together, make sure you put these back in. Set those aside in a safe place. And, all right. So I got a little bit of this junk to get out of the way from the intake. I might have to get a pick to dig this out. It's nice that they put an alignment hole, but it's unfortunately just a little on the snug side, so the gasket was just tearing out of there, the metal reinforcement part. Glued it in there. That's lovely. Wonder it didn't want to come out. Yeah, I just continue to dig around the edges of the holes, removing any traces of glue. Yeah, they were actually stuck in there pretty good, which was interesting to get all the glue remnant out and everything else. On this other one, I had to pry up, and it's like a metal reinforced piece wrapped in rubber. It's kind of a nice little setup. It doesn't pop off like a lot of the older designs did. Alright, next up, going around, scraping all the surfaces. Now I'm trying not to put anything in the valley. I should cover it up, but I kind of need access to it. I'm going to take the vacuum and suck all this up when I'm done. I'm just working on scraping the all the crustiness off of the face of the block there, all the rubber sealant, because in the corners right at the top of the where the head sits, there's a bunch of RTV that gets put on from the factory. So but yeah, now we're gonna break out the vacuum and get all the major debris sucked up. I'll go back through and clean and degrease all this before it all goes back together, and actually after I get done honing the surface. And this block is just set aside for doing nothing but hone work, so it's a nice square block. And I'm just making sure I'm alternating my pattern and then also staying where I'm spanning each of the bores. So that way I don't end up making a low spot as I'm working around it. And then just keep changing your direction and just working it over and over again. Or just doing a quick wipe to see where we're at. And we'll continue on working away here in a moment. So I think I ended up going at doing another round. Oh, I missed a little spot. I like to keep going when I'm honing till the point where you have a really nice uniform look over the entire surface. You can usually see where some areas need to be just worked a little more. I keep the pressure the same as I'm working it, so that way I don't end up dipping down one spot more than the other. But it's kind of get a feel for it after a while. and usually it'll come out pretty good. And then also keep an eye out for the machining marks that are left over. Oh, and here I'm just cleaning up some of the big crusties and giving another quick wipe down while we keep working it over. So as you can see, we got it down to really nice machine surfaces on both sides of the head. You can see the original tooling marks still there. A little discoloration isn't the end of the world, but specifically right around these rings here, we got to make sure those are all real nice and perfect. But yeah, so far so good. This cleaning up really nicely. Alright, so we're going to clean this head up much the same way we did the block. Do a pre-scrape to get the bulk of the gross off, and then we'll clean up all the, just lightly buff the surface down. Oh, and we got a roll pin. Let's come out. Alright, and here I'm just working the surface, getting the bulk of the crustiness off. Then I'm going to start working the different faces, just going around. This is actually a good time if you have a brass brush or something other than steel, even a stainless brush, to remove any additional carbon. I forgot that I didn't pull the intake gasket off on this side. The other side, I did that before I brought it over. Continuing working my way around the intake coolant passage, and then around each of the faces, trying to remove the bulk of stuff. So yeah, and this surface here, it's not so critical to get it perfect. I won't even hone this surface because it's just for the valve cover gasket. But the intake, the exhaust, and the head surface are the most critical of the bunch. Unfortunately, this stud is actually broke off. It was kind of that way when we I just found the broken off piece down inside the heat shroud. So it's been rattling around in there for quite some time. But we'll try to drill this and see if we can extract it. Alright. I'm just continuing to check, make sure I'm staying centered in the bolt. You don't want your drill bit to walk off. That's why I took the time to use my center punch. It was actually a transfer punch I used to get a nice deep impression, and then make sure you don't drill all the way through the head or into the head.
Cool. And that's the result. Alright, I realized when I got to looking at it that these threads are a little bit buggered up. So we're going to take a moment and just chase it with the tap. Just to make them nice and clean for when it all goes back together. And that should just hand spin in. There we go, just like we knew what we were doing. And this is 8mm by 1.25 thread pitch on these. Alright, so we'll just get this cleaned up.
Alright, so just giving a little spray to lube it up and working this face. The exhaust face isn't as critical. I'm just trying to knock down the big high spots, and especially where I had to drill that that stud out, it had a little bit of scarring on the face. So I ended up going another pass, and then the rear one as well also had some scarring. And but yeah, a little more buffing, and it's almost unnoticeable now. So the new gasket should seal up pretty good. These are a multi-layer steel gasket, and it comes in with the head kit. So I'm definitely going to be doing both the front and the rear head while I'm there, just so that way it'll never leak for the owner.
All right, now we're going to check for warpage. So I like to take a little piece of a round stock, roll it over, make an even bite everywhere that it matters. So that's a 2/1000. That 1/1000 isn't in the greatest of shape. And the 1/1000th one even go in. So we're close enough for that face. And now we'll do the main face here.
So here we're just setting up, and we're gonna clean up the head gasket face. Unfortunately, my recording device decided to not magically fill up its SD card, even though it wasn't full, and I ended up having to fight with that to get it where it actually records stuff again to the SD card. But the rest of this little short clip is me cleaning up the final faces, and we'll have to resume on the second head and show the process of checking for warpage and everything else while we check it. But this one actually turned out just fine, so no big deal.
Alrighty. So we got head number 2 over here. I had a little incident with some footage, so we lost my camera reset and lost all the footage from checking the head for flatness and warpage. It actually came out really nice. There's less than a thousandth of warp in the whole thing. So we're going to, I'll do repeat the procedure on this head so that way you guys can actually see what I did. Even though I showed it a little bit when I was checking the intake runners. But definitely a lot better than the last vehicle I did head gaskets on. That was way out of spec. And it ended up working out okay in the end. It recovered and...
Yeah, it's just a series of 10 millimeter bolts that hold the heat shield on. And there, on the one corner, there's actually supposed to be another bolt that was missing. Probably rattled out at some point. I think I have some more 10 millimeters that we can do. And then just giving everything a quick soak to help break everything loose. And most of those studs pulled out. I'm still debating whether I'm going to separate the nut from the stud or just reassemble them as one piece. If I separate them out and clean them all up, then it'll and then anti-seize everything, it'll put back together, and the next guy coming along will be able to take it apart and have a better better experience working on stuff. So
that one will come out.
And just continue to work my way around this one, or this face, cleaning everything up. Yeah, you saw me do this with the previous one, going around the valve cover area. There's a little burr on there on the corner where I was prying on the intake. I'll have to clean that up before it all goes back together. Getting all the crusties off the intake side again. And again, I'm going to have to go through and clean these heads real good. So there's a lot of oil and stuff, and I don't want the oil to interfere with the gasket material. There's actually a big old pile of crusty gasket material on the intake side from the head gasket that was not failed. It was on its way, though.
All right. So this one's about ready to do the main cleanup on, and we'll check it for flat. All right. Just gonna in line it up. We'll just check across those points. That's with our 2,000th. Try again with our 1,000th. Nothing. So it appears this head is good to go. I'm going to do another pass over this just to take polish it a little bit more. You can see it, we haven't even kissed all the original machining marks away. But fortunately, the owner was real careful with this car and didn't overheat it with the head gasket issue. So at least not enough to warp the head at all. And I'll do the same process on the block, but from what I'm seeing in the heads, I don't think there's going to be an issue in the block either.
All right, so we're just continuing on doing a second pass. Didn't really need it. It was a fairly light pass. I just thought it could use a little bit more polishing. Then we're going to continue working our way over. Oh, and hosed it down really good with some degreaser. I'm not really worried about damaging the spark plugs because I intend to replace them when we put this all back together. Yeah, most of the surfaces on this one cleaned up really nicely. As you see, I'm just doing a really quick pass. I mean, it only took a couple minutes per section to get them nice and flat. So, this is another surface where checking to make sure we don't have any major warpage because there's a lot of heat on this side. The manifolds can shift on you a little bit. The other side was actually better, or it's just as good. There was no warp in it, so I didn't think this side would be an issue, but we still check. And then I had one little tab for the intake gasket got stuck in the in this little retainer hole, alignment hole thing. That was kind of a little bit of effort to get out. But then got it out, face cleaned up really nice. Get everything all cleaned off, and even some of that black smudge from the head gasket came up too. So we'll try to get all that out before we reassemble everything.
Well, I'd like to thank everybody for watching. We're pretty much done with this video, so I'll bring you guys back when we put it all together. I'm gonna clean up this manifold here, well, both manifolds, get them all ready to prepped. I need to source another stud for the one that got broke off. Hopefully I have one in my random pile of stuff, so I don't have to make a trip into town. But yeah, pretty well straightforward. Both heads turned out really nice. I will give them a final clean before they go back on, you know, just to be sure. And I think I'm going to load both exhaust manifolds on before I set them in. Because the only reason I didn't pull them with the manifolds attached was because I had problems with one of the fasteners. But now that's been apart, it should go back together pretty well. But yeah, just a little cleanup and start reassembling.